how he could foresee how he could live the rest of his life. And then God called him into the ministry, and he dedicated his life. And for coming back from the conference, he began his work, and he started this, let us say, prayer center. And that last house, you know, he assembles people and conducts prayer meetings. The last time I was here, we also had something like this, and at that time he was able to bring in a number of people. And it all depends on what season we come to this place. This is the very poor housing area. The government granted these wastelands to the people of this area, to the poor people of this area, to build their houses. One Christian official was kind enough to include his name to get allotted a plot, which was allotted to him. This plot was allotted to him. And he has a burden to reaching out to all these Hindu, Muslim, all kinds of people were allotted these homes. Some of them finished their houses and were able to come in. Others could not complete, and still you can see half-built houses all over. And it's dangerous at nights, you know, it's all open places, snakes and all kinds of, you know, harmful insects are here. So people don't, electricity is very less, it is dark, and at this time God gave us this opportunity to come, and the faithful people already gathered here. He was hoping that because he invited people from wherever he works on a weekly basis, you know, he goes down to places, and his expectations proved wrong, and people did come. But the moment I entered here, I saw the situation. It reminded me of the ministry of Noah in the olden days. He used to tell everybody, come believe in God and see what we are doing. And you follow us, you do what we do, believe in God. You know, he preached, but nobody did listen to Noah's message. And the ultimate result was that only his family got saved in that flood. And many others at the end, at the last hour and last minute, as it began to rain, then they knocked, but to no avail. So this evening, I praise God for the faithful few. Amen. I praise God for the faithful brothers and sisters from the Victory Baptist Church, and who are willing to travel many, many long hours on the dangerous roads of India. Glory belongs to the Lord. And whatever God would do with his people, he would always do. And even though these are few, if we strengthen them, their faith, by preaching to them the word of God tonight, and praying for them to become even more stronger in their faith and their Christian walk, I believe one day, as this colony completes, and as people come and slowly take over their houses, begin to build and complete their houses, there will be thousands coming to this place, by which time there will be a small place of worship which this man has been praying about. And tonight we may be laying a cornerstone, but the Lord knows what to do with that, and what to do with this man's life, and how to really raise these people up to be strong witness in the area. Bidurala has been always been a Baptist field, when Baptist missionaries came, worked, and that generation passed. Now we are in another generation when people don't heed to the instruction from God's word. They want to live their own ways, and they want to pursue their own paths of life. But I'm glad today that God raised this young man to be a preacher. preacher at a time when people are mocking God and His church, and when people have chosen other wrong ways. But I praise God, tonight He is able to stand. You know, He is ministering to many people. He does personal evangelism. He goes not to Hindus' houses. ఎక్కడెక్కడ జరుగుతుంది చేసే వస్తాను.